Well, the Moreland Commission has released its recommendations to the governor and to the public. It's a 101-page document focused on political and ethical corruption here in the Empire State. And joining us now to talk more about the report, our political analyst, New York Post state editor, Fred Dicker. And Fred, you've been somewhat critical of the work of the Moreland Commission. So what do you think of the results of the Moreland Commission?
Well, there's kind of a collective yawn at the Capitol over this, which is not to say this isn't a serious matter. It is, but there really is nothing new in this report. It's very disappointing to those of us who have followed this very closely. Much of it reads like a rehash of the press conferences we've heard over the years from NYPERG or Common Cause, the other good government groups. Others look like they're right out of the newspapers from this year or TV shows, TV stories, because it just recounts all the different legislators who've been indicted. They don't seem to have come up with anything so far. There's some innuendo in there. They claim they found a legislator who may have gotten some money, maybe even been bribed, but they don't even name the legislator. They don't even say how the bribe would have taken place. Maybe we'll learn that down the road. Bottom line is, it's the same old, really. It's the Governor Cuomo's agenda from last spring, and there's no reason right now, anyway, given the legislature's reaction and even the governor's own reaction, to believe that any big change is coming.
Weren't a number of these proposals or suggestions from the Moreland Commission things that the governor himself had proposed during the legislative session?
They are. Not only that, Liz, I was doing some research. Many of these are things that were proposed by a Moreland Act under Governor, Moreland Act Commission, under Governor Mario Cuomo in 1987, 88, and 89. There's no easy solution to the problems that the money can create. But let me tell you, one way to solve it is to set an example. And tonight, Governor Cuomo is in New York City for a fundraiser for his campaign where you can pay as much as $50,000 a ticket. And a lot of people are scratching their heads saying, why would the governor do that the day after Moreland issued a report saying that there's a corrupting influence from money in politics? And there he is down in the city taking money from all the usual special interests and maybe a few others that we don't know about, but we'll learn about.
Well, maybe it's to get it in before there is some kind of change.
Could be, but there is something known as leading by example, and frankly, this is just the opposite. And you wonder why he's doing it. By the way, he put out a statement in response to his own Moreland Act Commission that was completely neutral, saying he thanked them for their work. He's going to review the findings as if he didn't already know well in advance what those findings were going to be. So it's unclear how much, if at all, the governor is even committed to the recommendations made by the commission.
Do you think that there will be changes, that these kinds of events that are taking place tonight will eventually just sort of go away, or no?
I don't think so. I mean, this is a very big state. We've got six media markets. It's very expensive unless you're going to have the government provide sort of welfare for the politicians and pay all the costs, TV and radio ads, all that involves in a campaign, polling, phone banks, et cetera. I don't think what we've seen in polls, the public doesn't want that. But absent that, you have to have a way of raising money. And merely having publicly disclosed special interest money coming in may not, and I don't think it is in and of itself, pointing to corruption.
All right. Very interesting stuff. Thank you, Fred. We'll talk again soon. Fred's on the radio, live from the state capitol, weekday mornings. It's on at 10 until 11 on Talk 1300 AM radio.